Hello, 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 everyone, and welcome back to the recipe of the week. I was in Mobile for 3 days, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and on my way back, I had an encounter. I was listening to my worship music, and I was thinking of a situation that my friend was going through, and this song came on called Speak Your Name by Anthony Brown and Group Therapy, and I began thinking about the situation that my friend was going through. And I had a word for her simply because when we speak his name, everything moves out of the way. Power comes in the room. Power is released. Everything has to fall down, has to flee, get off of you, get back, step back, go on about your way. Anytime we speak the name of Jesus. So the words of the song says, when we speak your name, something happens in the room. Our hands go up. We can't wait to see what you're gonna do. When we speak your name, power is released. As we bow down before you, every demon has to flee. So I began studying Acts 3, and it's one of my favorite passages of scripture, where there was this man that he was crippled from birth. And Peter and John were getting ready to go to the temple to pray. And he was looking for them to give him alms, A-L-M-S, money, gifts. But the gift that they gave him lasted eternally. The name of Jesus. They began speaking and praying. And all of a sudden, this man that was crippled from birth was healed. By and under the name of Jesus. Somebody say the name of Jesus. So I'm reading from Acts 3 Amplified Version. I'll be reading verses 1 through 7 and the verse 16. And the verse 16 is the concentration scripture. And the word of the Lord reads, now Peter and John were going up to the temple at the hour of prayer, the ninth hour, 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Verse 2, when a certain man crippled from birth was being carried along, who was laid each day at that gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, so that he might beg for charitable gifts from those who entered the temple. Press pause. So it's so sad that these people were carrying him. Lord God Jesus. These people were carrying him and they could not heal him. There are some times where people that you are around you cannot do absolutely anything for you if they don't have a prayer life. If they don't have a prayer life and know Jesus, they're just carrying you. You're just around them. There is absolutely nothing that they can do for you. Verse 3. So when he saw Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked them to give him a gift. Verse 4. And Peter directed his gaze intently at him, and so did John, and said, look at us. Verse 5. And the man paid attention to them, expecting that he was going to get something from them. He thought he was going to get some money. Verse 6, but Peter said, silver and gold money I do not have, but what I do have that I give to you in the use of the name, somebody say the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. He spoke to the man, walk. Now, let's go back. The other people that were carrying him were just carrying him. No purpose, just carrying him. Verse 6 says that Peter spoke the name Jesus and said, walk. Now let's get to the meat of the matter. Verse 7. Then he took hold of the man's right hand and with a firm grip raised him up, and at once his feet and ankle bones became strong and steady. Concentration scripture, verse 16. And his name, through and by faith in his name, has made this man whom you see and recognize well and strong. Yes, the faith which is through and by him, Jesus, has given the man this perfect soundness of body before all of you. The people that were carrying didn't really have anything for him. They had something that was temporary. Jesus Christ. Temporary. Sometimes people that are around you are temporary. They don't have anything for you that's going to last for eternity. John and Peter gave him Jesus, offered Jesus to him. I want to go back to the song that I was telling you about. Speak the name. Speak your name. Anytime you speak the name of Jesus, demons have to flee. Everything has to flee. Everything has to get back up, get from around you. Let me play a little bit of this song here.
We can't wait to see what you're gonna do.
Power is released. Demons have to flee. We call on Jesus to show up and show out Jesus. Move how you want to move, Jesus. You can do what you want to do, what you want to do. To show up and show out Jesus. Move how you want to move, Jesus. You can do what you want to do, what you want to do. Listen. Jesus came at them speaking, Peter and John speaking and praying for this man. And Peter said, walk at the name of Jesus. This man was healed. Show up and show out, Jesus. Show up and show out. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We thank you for your son, Jesus. And by his name, people are being healed right now. In the name of Jesus. People need you right now, Lord. They need you to show up and show out in their lives. They're desperate. They're depressed, Lord God. They are just hopeless. And I ask that you dispense and disperse the angels that are assigned to their situation right now in the name of Jesus. And we speak the name of Jesus. Because we know when we speak the name of Jesus, everything has to move. Things have to clear up. Things have to be set in order and in place. And we thank you. And we honor you in Jesus' name. Amen. You guys have an amazing week. And remember, before you speak to Sally and Paul, speak the name of Jesus. He's going to show up and show out in your life on this week. I love you, but most of all, God loves you bigger and better than I ever could.